Alright guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome to Survival Russia. We are at the camp today, as you can see. We had to clean out a little bit with the scythe there, the old early 1900s scythe, original from the homestead, wooden handle, everything. But we're also here to check out, I don't know if we can see it, but a very interesting, very awesome Russian handmade axe from a company called Petrograd. I bought a few axes from them a few months ago and I've been testing them out, and back then I said that I would be surprised if they are not as good, at least, as the Grand Force axes. Alright guys, so I managed to clean out the camp here a little bit, didn't take very long, but we are not here to clean out or making clean out camp videos. I'm here to show you today this Carpenter's axe from Petrograd, because this is a really really awesome axe. Some of my viewers think that I'm not really that happy about axes, because in many of my survival related videos I will always pick a good saw, like a silky saw of course, right? Instead of an axe. That is simply because a saw is much more efficient at making firewood in an environment like this. I can always make the Siberian log fire and blah 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 blah. And for campfires in general, it's not really that needed to split wood. So generally, when I'm using an axe, it's always in some kind of fixed camp scenario. Whether I'm out with a tent and running a stove where I need to split wood, then of course an axe is really really awesome. If I'm here somewhere else, I want to build something, then an axe is also great, in combination with the saw of course. But I decided to get a carpenter's axe from Petrograd. Actually, Petrograd's online shop, they actually sell the Grandforce axes and the Wetterling's axes and so on. But then I ran into these guys here, saw it's their own in-house production. And I will post some pictures here, I think, just so you can see the workshop, and by the end of the video I'll show you all the pictures that they sent me, because I've decided to help them out to be known in the Western community, you can say, because these axes are really really awesome. As some of you also might know, that sometimes I choose to promote some company, whether it's Russian or Finnish or whatever, Japanese. And it takes me a good time to find out if I want to do that or not. Because not only do I have to test out the products, I also have to find out if the company website and so on, if they are trustworthy and reliable and all this stuff. So Petrograd, they fall into this category. They make awesome products, handmade, and not many of you guys know them, of course, because they are Russian, and there's a huge language barrier, right? Russia is an ex country, so I contacted them and decided to help them out. So they have translated their website into English, or part of it anyway, and they will ship with the PayPal and all that good stuff. So what is there to say about the carpenter's axe here? The axe head itself is made from steel, which in Russian is called G65, which I don't know the Western equivalent to G65, but G65 is a spring steel, and seems to me to be pretty solid steel. I have no issues with it at all. The handle here, I am pretty sure this specific handle is made from maple. They use the different material handles for different axes. But to start out with, I want to show you some footage I made at the homestead, where I'm comparing this little guy here to my Hultafors Akdor. They're the same size. What we have here is the Hultafors Akdor. I use this a lot. I carry this a lot in the woods when I carry an axe. And here we have the Petrograd carpenter's axe. You can see they both have a protective sheath, where the Petrograd sheath here is a little bit more awesome than the this Ultraforce thing here. One thing I will most likely point out up in the woods here is that you can see the profile on them. This is very, very slim profiled, where the carpenter's axe is a little bit heavier. The pommel here, or whatever it's called, anyway, the back of the axe, you can see the Ultraforce is a little bit larger. The Ultraforce axe here is actually very thin. Let's say, yeah, 2 millimeters maybe or something like this. This is more robust as a tool. But the point here is that for an all-round axe, the carpenter's axe here, the Petrograd carpenter's axe, is much, much better to split wood than this little guy here. They're of course very different, and they can do different things. But I'm testing this carpenter's axe here out as a, what you can call it, like a all-round carry axe for the woods. And so far, it's been really, really awesome. I think I'll go and weigh them and fill you in on the results up in the woods. The weight difference is less than 100 grams. I think the Arcdor weighs about 1180 grams, and this is 1214, so not that big a difference. So that was a little comparison between the two guys, and at the spring hunting trip I also made some footage with this axe here where I was using it for splitting wood. What I do when it's challenging to split wood is I try and split it here or here or something like this, just to get it split. But you can see there's knots everywhere, and this is what it is with spruce. Knots here, knots there. It's a nightmare to split spruce actually. But let's see how it goes. And if I meet too much resistance in one place, I move to another. And try to follow the different cracks it makes. So it actually went pretty easy this time here. Here split pretty nicely. There we have a nice knot. There we have a knot. There we have a knot. But the carpenter's axe here, even one-handed, is definitely not too bad. And of course it's not made for splitting wood, right? But it's always nice to try out stuff and see how tools they work. And carpenter's axes has a lot of good properties for bushcrafting, camp crafting, woodcrafting, crafting, right? And if it also can split wood to some degree, then it's only that much better. So I've been testing this guy here quite extensively at the homestead. I've been splitting quite a few logs. I've been making some simple wood framing for building a playhouse, kid's house, so I was splitting some big logs, some poplar logs and a bit of pine and so on. I used felling wedges for it. You can of course use wooden wedges, but the wooden wedges, they have to be seasoned, and if they're not super awesome. So yeah, wood. So felling wedges, I actually have them in my backpack. But the handle itself, if not loosened up or anything like that. And the pommel or the hammer side here, I've of course been using quite extensively with the wedges, and no problems. So I am pretty confident in this Russian axe here, let's just say it like that. So when I first introduced the axe here and the other axe and the Arze or Ads or whatever you call it on the channel here, many of you guys asked, where can I buy them, where can I buy them, or what company are they from, and tra-la-la-la-la. But it takes time for me to gain trust in a product and in a manufacturer, company, whatever you want to call it. So this is why this is the first video on the axes and the tools from Petrograd. I have bought quite a good amount of stuff from them actually, sharpening stones and all sorts of stuff from the in-house production. So guys, I hope you like the axe, and I hope you will check the links in the description. There will of course be links in the description to the axe section and to Petrograd in general. Also, make sure that you check out the footage here from the forge, from where they're making the axes and axe handles and all that good stuff, so you can have a look inside of the forge. The forge is located in St. Petersburg, former Leningrad and formerly Petrograd. That was what it was called during the SARS times. So guys, check the links in the description. Please consider supporting the channel and the vehicle project and all that good stuff. And until next time, get out and train, get it done. Do something awesome. See you in the next video, guys. Thank you for your time.